The redstone system in Minecraft is surprisingly powerful. Whenever you're using redstone in Minecraft, you're essentially creating a circuit. Whether you're making a simple piston door, a trap, a shop system, or a farm, redstone is secretly teaching you how computers work. Redstone can be thought of as binary. On means 1, off means 0. This is the language of computers, and every redstone build is built from logic. Just like the circuits inside your phone, here is where logic gates come in. Let's start simple with the NOT gate, which inverts the signal. If the input is on, the output is off, and vice versa. Next is the AND gate, which only turns on when both inputs are on. If both levers are on, then the output is 1. Anything else, it's 0. The OR gate is very simple, as it outputs 1 if either lever is on. For the NOR and NAND gates, you just invert the output signal. Here is where it gets interesting, the XOR gate. It only turns on if exactly one input is on, not both. Perfect for binary addition. It works by using the comparator in subtract mode, so the signal from the rear and side will be subtracted. Since both signals are equal, the output is 0, but since we're also powering another comparator and the other lever's signal is 0, then the input will remain the same for one comparator, thus outputting 1. So, why do these gates matter? Sure, they're cool to mess around with. But when you combine them, you unlock something powerful. With just a few gates, you can do math, like actually add numbers out in binary, just like a real computer does. But first, how do we add numbers in binary? Keep in mind that binary uses base 2, so each place value represents a power of 2, starting from the right. So let's add 3 and 2, which is 011 plus 010. We add the same way as in our system, except that 1 plus 1 is 010, so we carry 1 to the next place value. Let's focus on the first column. We can see that there can be 4 states, 0 plus 1, 1 plus 0, 0 plus 0, or 1 plus 1. We see that if x and y are different, then the output is 1. We can represent this as an XOR gate. If x and y are equal, then the output is 010 or 2. We can represent this as an AND gate. We can use this knowledge to create a half adder to add 2 single-bit binary numbers. This is a half adder which we built using an XOR gate and AND gate. This works because the first place value is 1 if the inputs are different, but becomes 0 if they become similar. The carrion only turns on if both inputs are 1. This adder can now calculate up to 1 plus 1. However, a half adder is limited because it does not handle carrion from a previous addition. So let's build a full adder. To make a full adder, we just connect another half adder. This is the same as adding the first two numbers, then adding a third. The input variables are x, y, and z. We also have to note that z can be interpreted as the carry in from a previous adder. The main reason for this is that we can now connect full adders together to compute numbers in binary. This is called a ripple carry adder, or RCA. When we connect full adders, we are essentially moving up the place value. Ripple carry adders are simple, but cause a delay because the carry has to pass through each adder sequentially. Anyways, what about subtraction? Well, since we're using 4 bits, our maximum number would just be 1111 or 15. If we add one more, well, then we overflow, and it results in 0 since we're only using 4 bits. we've essentially wrapped around back to zero. This is a crucial concept in modular arithmetic. Since we're using 4 bits or 2 to the power of 4, we're going to use mod 16. The mod function basically just gets the remainder when we divide by the modulus, in this case, 16. For example, 5 mod 16 is 5, 8 mod 16 is 8. Our maximum is 15, so let's go higher and add 1. 16 mod 16 is 0, and 17 mod 16 is 1. We basically just wrapped around. How does this connect with subtraction? Well, let's say we want to subtract 4 from 5. The result should be 1, but how do we represent minus 4? Well, there is a cool trick where if you add 1100 or 12 to 5, you get 0001 if we ignore the overflow. Well, minus for mod 16 plus 16 is equal to 12 mod 16. And 12 mod 16 is just 12. We can add any multiple of the modulus because we won't be changing the remainder. Also note that minus for mod 16 is not equal to minus 4. This is because remainders in modular arithmetic are positive. Also note that 12 fits the definition of a remainder. So adding by 12 is the same as subtracting by 4 and 4 bits. What we basically did was turn 0100 into 1100. We basically inverted all the bits 1011 and added 1 to get 1100. We just derived 2's complement, which states that the negative of a number is the same as flipping all of the bits of the original and adding 1. With this, we can basically do subtraction using our ripple carry adder. For example, 10 minus 2, that's 1010 minus 0010. The result should be 1000. We can do the same thing by just adding 1010 and 1110. Ignoring the overflow bit, we get 8. Also, subtracting using this method works for any bit size, like 8-bit, 16-bit, 32-bit, etc. With addition and subtraction figured out, the possibilities in Minecraft Redstone start to open up big time. Now, I won't go into detail about multiplication and subtraction here, however, those operations are built using addition and subtraction. Moving forward, you can build things like 8 segment displays. These take binary numbers and decode them into the decimal digits we actually read. You'll also want ways to store bits, like memory circuits, so you can keep track of numbers, states, or progress. Basically, the simple /off of Redstone Dust is the same binary language computers use, and from there, you can build complex systems like calculators, games, and so much more. So, next time you're building with Redstone, remember, you're actually using the foundations of computer engineering.